Jennifer didn't have any siblings. She didn't know how to fight back verbally. She didn't. She just took it and took it and took it every single day. Now, could I have helped her? Could I have saved her life? I don't know. But nobody gave me an opportunity to try. The year prior to that at Tompkins, I was doing a temporary contract out at Wrights High School in Evansville. Wrights High School, 1,700 students. And I get a call one Saturday morning, "Ms. Titzer, you remember so-and-so?" And I said, "No." He says, "Well, let me tell you what was going on. The boy had been suspended for 3 days. He had 2 hearing aids. He was an honor student. But because he had hearing aids, he was under the special education umbrella. When he was 18 months old, he had an ear infection, which caused hearing loss, and that's why he had 2 hearing aids. But this group of people, guys and girls alike, would come up behind, first someone would go, basically, "Can you hear me now?" They would try and sign something. He'd go, "What do you say? What do you say?" And they would turn up his hearing aid. And at that time, they would always send a messenger around, "Ah!" and would scream in his ear. You scream in someone's ear with a hearing aid, you might as well put the knife in and twist it. It literally makes them buckle. Oh, and they would just laugh. Ah! Well, because when he was 18 months old, he was learning how to talk and articulate language. He could not verbalize very well. So he would then chase him, because they would be like, "Watch the retard chase me. Come on back here, man. I'll kick your ass right now. Come on back. I'll kick your ass right now." Listen to the retard talk. He was an honor student. And other kids saw it happening and did not tell anyone. I don't blame Wrights High School. I was his counselor. You know, if anybody should be blamed, I guess it would be me. Tompkins, Jennifer's death, this boy's death out of Wrights. These are no accidents. This is a matter of other students to go, "Dude, stop it. It's not funny." And until students start to say, "Come on, let's go tell him. You guys leave him alone. Leave him alone. Let him go." He wrote in his note that very same week, Dad had lost his job from a back injury and had to go on disability, which meant he had to be off work for 3 full months with no check before he would get his disability check. Mom had to go back to work, and she had not worked his whole life. So here she was out trying to get applications for jobs. He suspended out 3 days. On that 3rd day is when Mom had a job interview, and Dad took Mom to the job interview. He wrote his note. "I'm sorry that I can't hear. I'm sorry that you guys are filing bankruptcy. I'm sorry that Dad can't work. Maybe it would be better if I just die and my life insurance can help pay the bills for the next 3 months until your check comes in." He goes out to his dad's truck, takes the shotgun out of the back window, and blows his head off. These are not accidents. That is not the answer to someone saying something mean to other students.